Okay. Right. Hello. Welcome to Starmade. I'm going to demonstrate my DemoRockDragger. It's an old ship that I built when I was first learning Starmade. And I didn't really have a lot of experience in building. So I developed a purpose to build something, and it was going out and gathering up asteroids to do something with them, build something, build on them, harvest them, just mess around with them basically. I was just intrigued by the whole idea of this universe that you can just go and fully gather things up. Here it is here. This is my old dragging ship. Right, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this out somewhere because this lag is just killing me. Just undock this thing. See, it's got two linkages, fore and aft, and they are made of flex doors. Oh, no, that's right, the ends are. To give you an idea on what I've done with this thing, is we will go over here. There we go. Now over here, I have a collection of rocks that I have collected, and they've been sitting in my server since I first started collecting them. It's not long after I first deployed this server. So as you can see, I build links, chain links on the actual asteroid itself, so that I can link up with the asteroid and drag it. Now, this is a blast from the past. This is one of my early builds. It's a really budget looking ship. It's got a hatch there. What the heck is it doing here? I think my stuff is somehow drifting. Anything that's not bolted down, which is pretty much why I dock everything now. Okay. Find some rocks. design isn't the greatest. Okay. I was just beginning, just learning. Now, let's pick a rock that's not too big. Oh, actually no, let's just go for the blue one. So basically all I do is I just cruise off the corner. And, oops. Get close to the surface, not too close. Jump out. Now, I haven't done this for a long time, so just bear with me because it's been a while. So I'll just get whatever blocks and is going on. Oh, I know what it is. Forgot about that. It's the click stores. Build the I don't know how it goes. One, two, three, four, five, six. Is it six? Two, three, yeah, there's five. Now that I have it built, what I can do is I can actually rest it on there now. Now we so, just keep building the chain link out. What on earth? Build the link and I'll go fix the ship later. Seems to be some sort of drama. Oh, that's right. Wait a minute. Stuff back. never seen that happen before. Okay. Alright. Let's do this at the same point. Have our link. Now I need my ship. Wait. This is trippy. What's going on? Huh? What's that? Oh, that's the old ship. I like to think that it came and grabbed it. Go in my wee museum. At the very least, I think.
Ah.
Save the blueprint. I don't know if I saved that blueprint. In the early days, I didn't really know how to do much at all. Basically, I just have to just line myself up, as long as I'm perpendicular, or roughly perpendicular, I should be right. The threshold like that. And I can just close the gap. But I just realised I don't really want to use this one. It's for manoeuvring. I really want to use the rear. Link. Now, to demonstrate, I'll just light forward, and initially you have to be quite gentle because it can break the link, like the bond will just break apart, and it will not come with you. Now, all I need to do is navigate home, turn this rock around. Got very fast at pulling these things, but there is an interesting thing that that I have learned, and that's when you get close to the edge of a sector, that can happen. Basically, the rock will not go across the sector attached to a ship. There is a trick to getting it across the threshold between sectors. I've done it many times, and that is to gently nudge the asteroid so it floats freely across the threshold. You can see at the top I'm at 2 minus 1, 2. See how my sector coordinates changed. See, if I just go a fraction forward past the asteroid, it'll change to 202. There. So there's a gap that we have to get the asteroid over. Now there's another way of doing it. Ramming speed! Bonk! There we go. Let's get another shove. See, as long as I'm not touching it, when it gets over there, we're home free. Further to go. Here we are, we're over the threshold. So now I can link up with this thing. Let's just get into position. Oops. Make this work. I've had lots of fun dragging these things around in the past. I think what I'll do is I'll just not talk from now and speed this up until we get into sector 222. It's going to take a while to get this thing there. Well, I don't know what the hell's going on there, but I'm just going to leave these things floating around because I've got no idea why they keep glitching out like that. Things seem to be more touchy-feely. I don't like to be touching stuff. So, let's just leave it. There's my rock dragging ship. It's not the greatest looking thing. It's just a tug, basically. An ugly looking tug. And the reason why I have these flex doors coming all the way back to the core is because I didn't know at the time. I didn't know at the time that you could connect things to the core and have them on the hot bar. So I just used what limited knowledge I had. What is it? Oh, no. Yeah, so it was before I learned how to do that. Let's go and park this thing back and leave the rocks where they are. My old shuttle pods. I wonder if the guys are still hanging out in there. Hey guys. How's it hanging? What's going on? Dude, you need a shave. Oh, that's us. Thank you for watching.